As you guys probably know, I used to live in Florida. One big thing about Florida is that there's a lot of Disney adults as you get closer to Orlando. And let me tell you something, right? I had the opportunity to actually see a little bit behind the scenes of like a lot of the workers at Disney and Disney adults. And let me tell you something, a lot of you Disney adults are fucking weird as shit. So because of that, we're gonna write a video titled, Who's the Biggest Disney Fan?
To all who come to this happy place.
All right, this is gonna sound a little fucked up, but I think I know who is not the biggest Disney fan.
Hi friends, hi folks.
Okay, based off of looks, I just wanna point out the amazing Disney bound here.
I think I just wanna-
Disney bounding is dressing like a Disney character using regular clothes. It's a fun way to embody a favorite character without wearing a full costume. Sounds like it's some goddamn ritual or some shit.
Go ahead and start out by asking you to come right over here.
Yes. That's valid. Visually, I've just never seen so many pins before.
Oh, hey, Chandler. Yeah. Okay, yeah. 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 Come right here. You wear Disney every day.
Every day, my life, yeah. Never comes off. She should move up further. You're more like bubbly, outgoing, yeah. So I think.
Okay. Yeah.
Like maybe.
You look like you're on your honeymoon.
Right here, yeah.
I'm just gonna go down here, I feel like. Because I'm just wearing all black.
I'm just in a t-shirt and a hat, though. And you have the bracelet, too.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Perhaps I should move to the end since I'm in the least Disney garb.
But it's a spirit jersey. It's a classic.
Yeah. I feel like you have a lot of knowledge. I'm looking at you. I think you have a lot more knowledge than you're putting on. So I think you
My
should
Disney
come.
Adult is more of a personality thing, I think. Like, I don't visually.
Oh, so he's the worst kind of motherfucker. He said, Disney is like a personality thing. Well, guess what? You have no personality.
I don't know.
I feel like there's different types of Disney adults, yeah. And there's some who like have the total aesthetic and the collections. Yeah. And then there's those who have just the magic and the personality.
The absolute happiness of Disney.
And that's so you.
That's such a Disney thing to say.
One or two.
You guys want to switch?
Sure,
okay,
yeah.
We'll switch.
Okay. Or, we can switch with you too.
Are you sure?
Okay. Yeah.
All right, we're locking it in.
Yeah, locked in.
They looked at me, saw my pins and my tattoos.
I know this motherfucker didn't pull up with the motherfucking custom Disney WWE Championship right here. I mean, good for Michael. I mean, I'm trying to be positive, but good for Michael. Man's is being himself. That's all anyone can ever ask of. At least make the title better, bro. Like, you know what I mean? I don't know. Go to people that WWE goes to make their titles. If you're a real diehard Disney fan, you will do that. You'll pay a couple racks for a custom-made WWE Disney-inspired championship.
Top, I'm like, whoa, that was surprising. Most of my life, people looked at me, and it just see a guy with tattoos and with a beard and everything. You wouldn't think, oh, this guy listens to princess music on the way to work every day, or works out to Once Upon a Time in the gym or anything like that.
Disneyland Championship. If you can dream it, you can do it. The DLC World Heavyweight Champion. I don't know if I ever want to be that shit, man. You listen to fucking Disney singing as your workout music, bro, like, you have a whole new level of insanity, man. Like, I feel like a little bit of an asshole for saying this, but tell me Michael doesn't look like the guy from Toy Story, the chicken suit guy. I used to work with a motherfucker who looked just like the chicken suit guy. He was a bit of an annoying motherfucker, too. Oh, man, I couldn't be around the nigga. I'm sorry. I already know you about
this. This is my very first pair of ears in 1995. Aww. My mother kept this. My nickname is Tiger. My entire family calls me that. They don't call me Michael, they call me Tiger. And then of course, the loud and proud, obviously the Disneyland Championship. So I literally carry this every time I go.
See, I don't know Michael, but if he's like a pro wrestler, that would make sense. You know what I mean? That could be his whole gimmick. I can't even hold you. Like when I get married and shit, I'm gonna have a fucking custom belt too. So I can't really talk all that shit. I'm not gonna be carrying it everywhere I go. That's the only difference.
This is Pluto from Tokyo. Pluto is my absolute favorite, in case people tell. And this is my Club 33 pin.
What? Oh my God, yo. I literally had a conversation with someone who literally works at Disney, right?
Well, it's basically imitation too, but I believe it was like 25,000.
My Club 33 pin.
Wow.
And I got to go one time, and so I splurged on a pin.
I grew up going to Tokyo.
Oh, okay. So she only done it once. Okay, never mind. I take that back.
Okay, so this little guy right here, he's supposedly from Japan, 1960s, roughly. He also squeaks for some reason.
I love it.
So, like, these are supposed to be his legs, but yeah.
When you spread it like that, I don't know.
These are his feet, I guess.
So I brought my favorite movie, The Little Mermaid. This is the...
Yo, before my family threw it out, I swear, on my VHS with the orange cassette tape that played Rugrats in Paris, I used to have this shit too. Because I remember every time a Disney movie will play on a VHS, a giant fucking THX logo will fucking play.
First VHS tape that my mom got me. I used to watch it like on repeat, like every single day for a couple hours.
You guys want to rearrange yourselves based off of those possessions?
You're the champ.
This thing is throwing me off.
I'm so sorry. The only way you can search this up is through reverse Google image search. Like, that's how obscure.
Okay, you should move.
Oh, okay, so I guess we're just capping. I'm gonna see who's bullshitting right now, actually. Hold up. Yeah, he's right. Yeah, you know what? I am wrong. I was wrong. I can't find the shit. So, yeah, nigga was right.
Favorite Disney park or experience you guys have been to?
Dapper Day. I love
Dapper Day. So much fun.
Going in the grad night, just in the park with thousands of kids here. If you're going to Disneyland.
If it's just me and my wife, then we're here. Space Mountain, Star Tours, Indiana Jones, Galaxy's Edge, come back to Matterhorn, which is the whole plan.
You know that scene in Lion King, the one that we don't want to talk about, the wildebeest are just...
Yes, that's literally what it's
that's
like.
People that-
I feel bad, bro, because she literally pumped her arms too while she was running, like she was running. Why do they do like a running gag with the person who's unable to run?
Rope drop.
I've lost the parent to rope drop.
Oh no. How much do you guys spend on a typical day at a Disney park?
College student, so like at maximum $30.
$30.
I have a shopping problem.
Yes, I'm in debt, but that's okay. I'm in Disney debt, and that's happy debt. So
how much in debt are we talking? Are we talking like, you know, a couple hundred dollars? Are we talking about a couple thousand? Like, what are we talking about here? I'm gonna be real. Like, you're willing to go into debt over a corporation. That's like professional NBA level dick riding.
All right, let's switch.
I spend like $60-$70 here.
Get over here. Come on.
You're making me feel so cheap right now.
I know. I feel so poor over here.
Disney on a budget, solid. Disney on a budget. Yay.
Do you guys want to get into what Disney means to you guys?
It started from when I was a kid watching the movies because we couldn't afford to go to the parks as much. So I would watch a lot of Disney movies, and Little Mermaid was my first introduction to Disney.
Source of happiness. It's like, I don't have to think about like student loan debt or I can just like forget about everything and then just like go back to like happy nostalgic times when I've been there with my friends or like family members who might not be here anymore. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That got real sad real quick.
Especially when they had cookie decorating at the parks, so we'd go during Christmas time. And then we'd go with my dad a lot too. And
That sucks.
But it's nice to like to go there and then like sort of like, oh hey, this was his favorite ride. This was my great grandma's favorite food, stuff like that, and like kind of like relive that, and then just kind of imagine how they would think of like how the park has changed since then.
I grew up in Japan, and Disney is like the first exposure to Western movies for Asian kids, I would say. So, you know, every Japanese kid knows about Disney movies. And I also, I don't know if we can get into this, but I feel like in defense of Disney adults, a lot of...
Oh, here we go. She's going to try and defend Disney adults. I've seen Disney adults like in real life, in front of me. Them niggas are weird. Like, the only motherfuckers I fuck with who are Disney adults are like the Jedi ones, like the guys who are like into Star Wars and shit.
To all who come to this happy place.
Welcome. Disneyland is
your land.
Here age relives fond memories of the past. And here you may share the challenge and promise of the future. Disneyland is dedicated to the ideas, the dreams, and the heart facts that have created America.
Do I have to say any more? They just proved my point.
Thank you. Can you guys talk a little bit about, some of you have brought up like the money aspect of Disney.
Oh, God.
Yeah. Oh,
it's sad, but Disney is kind of the wealthy people's vacation now, and it's not very accessible to people.
There is such an immense privilege I think all of us have to be able to go to the park once, let alone multiple times. I mean, I have a relative who waited like 70 years of her life just to be able to go to Disney. That was like her one dream, and she finally got to go, and it was the most special thing. I hope people don't take it for granted, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Disney used to be, well, growing up, my dad never told me this, but he would literally go broke and work double shifts for us to go to Disneyland. And I didn't know, I was a kid. I was like, oh yeah, he's my inspiration to work two jobs to take my girls to Disneyland, let them have the experience I did. My oldest daughter is named Aurora, after Sleeping Beauty, and my youngest is named Ariel, after Little Mermaid.
Naming your kids after Disney characters is fucking insane. Michael, you seem like a cool dude, but that's crossing the line. That's too much for your boy Skinny P right there. I can't handle that much.
In seventh, we have Anna 34 times.
How did I know she was gonna be last?
Yeah. In sixth,
she's too cool.
Jack 50 times.
Damn.
In fifth, Rosie 185 times.
Oh my Jesus Christ.
What is happening?
No wonder why she's in debt.
In fourth, Grace 270.
Oh my god damn.
In third, Michael, 900 times.
What?
Oh my goodness.
But the champ.
In second, Kaylee, 2,000 times.
2,000?
I don't believe that shit.
Bro.
Caitlin, 5,000 times.
5,000?
Wow. Why do you count that? Oh, yeah.
I don't fucking believe that shit. Hold up. Nah. For the sake of getting like a rough estimate, let's just say she paid roughly $109, right? 109 multiplies by 5,000. Either her family or her by herself spent over $500,000 on just Disney alone. I could never imagine giving a corporation that much money and I don't own a part of it. Like, that's wild as fuck to me. If you gave me $500,000, I will guarantee I will do so much more with that $500,000 than she will ever do.